Hello, everybody. It's the coach. This is Madden 20 on EA Sports. Up next, we've got a good one on tap between the visiting Arizona Cardinals and the New Orleans Saints. With that, let's get over to the Mercedes-Benz Superdome with a call from New Orleans. Here are Brandon Godden and Charles Davis.
First opened back in 1975, there's a look inside the iconic Mercedes-Benz Superdome in downtown New Orleans. This is what it looked like just a moment ago in the heart of New Orleans. Folks, there's no place for this noise to go in the Superdome. It is loud, and these fans are ready for football as their Saints get ready to do battle with the Arizona Cardinals. Up in the booth with Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Godden, and kickoff straight ahead, CD. What's one thing that you're going to have your eye on?
I think about what the great coaches of the past always said, the key to any ball game. Can you rush theirs and protect yours? Well, in this case, both of these teams get after the quarterbacks. I'm watching the pass rush.
Kicker for the Saints, Will Lutz, has it teed up, and here we go from New Orleans. This fielded a few yards into the end zone, and no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line. So out come the Cardinals now for their opening drive. They will be led out by the Heisman Trophy winner from 2018, drafted number one overall the subsequent year, Kyler Murray. Strike here, Murray to Fitzgerald. The game's first play produces 6 yards, brings up second down.
One thing we do know, he's going to get his catches. So as they move forward defensively, got to continue to focus on not giving up the big play when he does catch the ball in the secondary.
They'll come up now, second and four from the 31. They'll run for the first time with Johnson. And he is met in his tracks behind the line of scrimmage. Officially, it will go as a 1 yard loss, and that's going to lead to a third down. What happened there? Was that just a missed assignment on the O-line?
It certainly felt like it, but also the speed of the play. When you talk about defensive end, they want to be ahead of the clock, don't they? They want to be upfield, making plays on every snap. How about his agility there to run that one down?
Third play here, this opening drive, as they're up against a third and five. From the gun on third down, Murray. Into heavy traffic, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Marcus Williams. And they'll start with great field position at the 41-yard line. Time will tell if that's an interception that rattles the rookie here. First drive on the road.
And you know the discussion going into the game? Centered on, okay, let's get out nice and easy, take care of the football, we're on the road. You're a youngster, let's not make mistakes early. But now the conversation will shift to, okay, put it behind you, move on. Long way to go in this one.
Out onto the field comes New Orleans. So after the INT, it's Breeze. He's got a first down and more inside the 30. And finally brought down at the 31-yard line. Give him 9 there on the first down completion.
There are so many things to watch for when you play defense. And reading your keys, you always hear about that, and having your eyes in the right place. Sometimes your eyes can fool you. How about that play action there? That sprang the big guy, didn't it?
Able to dump it over the top to him. They'll run it for the first time with Alvin Kamara. And he'll go down at the 28. 4 yards the pickup, first down.
Second and one is often an invitation to take the big shot downfield. I bet the offensive lineman said, are you kidding? We just get on our backs and let's go get the first down. They love being physical.
95-56.
Watch the twist. Check that. Staying on the ground on first with Kamara. So he got free of one tackle, but couldn't do a whole lot else. Corey Peters there to bring him down.
Early down stuff to put this offense in a precarious position. We know that securing the point of attack, especially against the big body guys in the middle of this D, has got to be priority one.
The last run good for two. Here's second and eight.
Okay, just like that.
Now Breeze, and brought in by the tight end Cook. They follow up the gain of two with a gain of one that time.
Well, they're unable to convert that into much, but it's never a bad idea to try to get the ball into a tight end of his caliber's hands and see what kind of disruption he can cause.
Ready? The Cards going nickel. An extra defensive back out there now on third down. Now Breeze. Looking for Thomas. He's got him. Touchdown, New Orleans. Michael Thomas. There to make the grab as his guys are able to strike first here in this opening quarter.
It's never fun for a defense to run on the field knowing that they're having to defend a short field. Just the idea of trying to limit an offense in that position, daunting for a defense.
Will Lutz on for the point after. Good as the Saints have a 7-0 lead. Five plays there on that drive, and it all culminates in a Saints touchdown. Touchdown, Lutz to kick it off. This fielded a few yards into the end zone. And no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line. Arizona getting ready to go as they take the field. They had the interception last time. It led to the opening touchdown. So now 7-0 to score as they start first and 10. Murray and the Cardinals with a first and 10 at their own 25-yard line. Trying to shake off the interception from the last drive. He'll look to throw. And from the 25, they work this to the 29, a gain of four. That throw good for four. It's second down. Second and six, just inside the 30. A first carry for Kenyon Drake. It's a 5-yard gain, but they'll still be a yard short here with third down now looming. And now a look at the Saints starting defense.
You can say a lot of things about the great play of Kiko Alonso, but the number one thing you will say, he will hit you.
And for the Saints here on third down, an extra defensive back on the field. Murray to throw on third and one. They'll roll him out right. He can run for it, and he will. And they'll get this well past midfield before being stopped just before the 35. It was third and short, and they go flying past the marker for a gain of nearly 30 yards.
That's something you have to be aware of as a defense and have to find a way to account for him. And if you're not going to use a spy, you're telling your guys to keep your eyes on him, because when he breaks out and makes plays like that, all he does is hurt you.
Have to at least be able to contain him somewhat. There they could not. So in Saints territory now, here's first and 10 at the 37-yard line. Counterplay, Drake. He'll get a nice chunk there on the first down run, and it's second and 4.
Despite the blitz, they're still able to pick up a nice solid gain. The disadvantage of blitzing often alters the normal spacing and run fits and leaves creases like they were able to exploit right there.
The last run got 6, now second and 4. A handoff out of the pistol, it's Drake. And they'll be inside the 25 now at the 24. 7 yards there and a first down.
Yeah, once more, strong running, excellent blocking at the point of attack. They've got a nice little drive brewing right here.
Off the draw, here's Johnson. And he'll run straight into a wall of tacklers at the line of scrimmage. It's second down. Delayed give there out of the gun. Defense was ready.
And I'm not a big fan of a draw play out of the shotgun formation because the quarterback's not having much action where he's getting away from the line of scrimmage. He's catching the football, making a little head fake, and then handing it off. You should be able to read it as they did there.
Looking to throw on second down. Murray. And this is going to be another first down as the tackle's made at the Saints 14. The last drive, remember, similar situation. He forced a ball into coverage through the pick. He learned better there.
Yeah, similar to a golfer that's confronted with a shot that you just can't make. Sometimes you have to take your medicine, as they say, right? Just pull it down, take off, and go. Don't make something worse than what it was.
All runs on this drive so far. It's first and 10. From the red zone, here's the Heisman Trophy winner, Murray. And now he's going to use his legs. And now they're inside the 10 as he's brought down at the 9. He'll get 5 out of the scramble. It's second down.
So many times we talk about having good eye discipline when you're playing defense, making sure your eyes are in the proper place on a given play. Looks like that discipline came to the front there, didn't it? They were able to hold him for a short gain when he took off running.
Looking to throw again on second down. Murray. And he'll take this one in for the Arizona touchdown.
Absolutely.
A 9-yard touchdown grab as his guys are on the board here in this first quarter. That pass also evens the ledger for the rookie quarterback. Had the interception earlier, and now he gets the touchdown throw.
The ideal touchdown-interception ratio is what, 3-1 for the best quarterbacks? But he's a rookie. Just getting back to even is a big deal. Increases the confidence his teammates have in him as he tries to become their leader.
Gonzalez good on the extra point, and we are tied at 7. So a nice drive put together there. They go 75 yards in 9 plays. And it winds up in a touchdown for Arizona. So all even at 7 now as they kick it away. This is taken at his 4. And he'll take this across the 25. Couple extra yards up to the 27-yard line. Back out onto the field now comes the New Orleans offense. And they had to wait a long time to get the football back. Probably not what you were hoping for when you got an offense that's humming.
Agreed. What you were looking for is the defense getting the ball back pretty quickly, right? Hoping for a three and out. So that didn't happen. You can't yell at your D for that. They've got to take care of their own business and reestablish themselves now that they're back on the field.
So Bree's going to lead the Saints up here, first and 10 at their own 27. Off the play fake to Kamara, it's Breeze. And that is caught on the right sideline, but out of bounds, says the line judge. The throw took him a little too far at second down. Before the game, they were running the route tree about as efficiently and effectively as we could have possibly imagined, but sometimes the passes just go awry.
Yeah, let's face it. When you're running the route tree in pregame, you don't have defenders breathing down your neck. You don't have defensive backs making plays on the football. Hard to replicate the intensity of the game in pregame.
They'll get nine there as that sets them up better for third down.
And when you're playing a quarterback with some experience and some moxie, you enter the danger zone when you decide to blitz him, because if he's able to diagnose as he did on that play, he can hurt you downfield.
He reads defenses so well, doesn't he?
He really does, and the best part about that play for him, I don't think that was his primary target.
I don't think so either.
I think he had the read, figured out where the blitz was coming from, and went to a secondary target for a really nice game.
That'll back him up 2 yards and also bring up fourth. And not what you're looking to do on third and one, completing the pass, but going backward.
I have zero explanation for that, because third and one, you just figure snap, throw, first down, right? Easy play, but end up losing yardage on it. That's hard to account for.
Here's Thomas Morstead on now to punt it away on fourth down. Back deep, the dangerous Pharaoh Cooper. And a great job on special teams to down it, as this will be marked down inside the 5-yard line.
That is how you flip field position. That's an absolute bomb of a punt. Downs it inside the 5-yard line. Absolutely ideal.
From that position, you're hoping to get it down inside the 15, inside the 5. Superb. Here's the Arizona offense now as they get set to take over. And they will start this drive with just terrible field position, backed up inside their own 5.
But we have seen teams be bold here and take shots, right? Sometimes you go max protection, make it a one receiver route, and take your shot downfield and see what happens. And occasionally, we've seen success occur.
They're going to go with a tight end here on the running play. And he'll find a little space. He gets this up near the 10. Big Sheldon Rankins there to bring him down.
I think they're ahead of schedule now after that run. They might be bold with this second down call after that type of a game.
Second and 5 now. Murray completes it to Fitzgerald. A Cardinal first down on a gain of 13.
A little football 101 there. You just see the receiver try to run down the defender, meaning he goes right at him and really trying to move him a little bit towards the center of the field so he can put his foot in the ground and break to the out to the sideline and make a catch.
Throwing on first down is Murray. It's complete to his tight end, Charles Clay. And he's going to get this one across the 30-yard line. 12 yards to pick up. Good enough for an Arizona first.
One of the advantages of zone defense, as I remember it, is being able to see the play develop in front of you. One of the disadvantages, when they find those levels where they can hit you with it. Sometimes behind the corner and in front of the safety, it makes it tough to defend.
On first down, Drake. And he'll get this one up to about the 39 here. It's a 6-yard pickup, and it gets him to 2nd and 4.
A quick burst there, and he nicely bit off a pretty decent gain.
Six yards on that last play. Here's 2nd and 4.
I'm coming after you.
They fake the handoff. Now Murray. He'll buy some time right. He'll try and run it. Give him seven on the tuck and run, and it'll get him a new set of downs. Well, Charles, in the past, a lot of people called this offense one-dimensional.
I think you did.
Well,
I think it was you.
I'll be honest, I did. But I think the fan base is hoping with this young rookie that they can put some wrinkles in this offense like we just saw.
I think you're exactly right, because we did have that discussion that what we've seen in the past from them, they needed to broaden, and they have done it here. Look at what he's bringing to their offense, and now as a defensive coordinator, you've got some extra work to do to prepare for him and their offense. I call that play a success. A nice inside run sets up a very manageable second down, a very solid gain on that play.
After the pickup of five, here's second and five. And now Murray's going to set up to throw. And he finds Fitzgerald. And this time he's able to take it down to the 42. 6 yards the pickup, and that's a first down.
This has to go down as one of the simpler routes in the playbook, but oh so effective. Nice completion there. Keeps the sticks moving.
Here we go. Hey, one more. Three ball.
On first down, it's Drake. Von Bell up to make the tackle.
What's the old expression, 3 yards in a cloud of dust? In this case, it's dust-covered pellets. It's no longer that old grass that we used to play on, right, and chew it up. Now we've got that artificial surface. You see the pellets go up. Still a nice play by the defense.
From the 39, Murray is complete to the tight end, Clay. And this time, not quite to the 30. It'll be down at the 31-yard line. That one, a first down pickup of eight.
When this offense can get their tight ends involved, they can move the football. Here, a nice route, able to look it in, and picks up the first down.
Murray going to lead his guys up first and 10. And he's 4 for 4 now, throwing the ball to start the drive. Now Murray. That's going to be caught by Kirk. And down inside the 15 he goes. It'll be an Arizona first down on a gain of 17. Down. Drake. So a nice job to break the one tackle, but not much daylight after that as he's brought down. Tackle there by Alex Anzalone.
Well, they had that one sniffed out. Excellent run blitz. Stopped that one for a short gain.
What makes a good run blitz a good run blitz?
The ability to stay on task, to follow up your assignment, go to the gap you're supposed to cover, and not be deterred by anything else.
A second down pass play there, but it's incomplete.
That's very well timed there defensively, because it's not a bad throw, but the collision came at the exact time he was reaching to bring in the football. Really, really well done.
Decent offense, just better defense. I think you're right. So the failure to connect on second down, that leaves him staring up here at a third and eight. Running from the gun, Johnson. And he'll be brought down well short of the first at about the 9-yard line. 3 yards won't be enough here as that'll bring up fourth down. We haven't seen much from him running the football here in this first quarter.
No, you're right about that. We haven't seen much of him at all so far. They've stacked him up pretty well. But when you're trying to run the football, sometimes you got to play the long game. Keep handing it to him, and some of those runs that aren't working now, they turn into 6, 7, 8, and maybe more later on.
Gonzalez's kick is good, and they take the lead here now at 10-7. So they get the field goal, but that was a 14-play drive to get three.
You sound like you're going negative on me.
I was.
Sounds like you're thinking the three is just not that good.
And people say that we're negative sometimes. So.
Well, here's the deal. Getting the three is good. Obviously, you would think on a 14-play drive you're going to get six out of it, but that type of a drive can pay dividends later on because you might wear the defense down.
After the field goal, here's Gonzalez to kick it off. Fielded about a yard deep. And he'll take this one near the 25, call it the 26-yard line. Out onto the field comes New Orleans. They punted last time they had it. What steps, Charles, you think they have to take to make sure they don't do that again?
Well, let's just go to the football 101, the trite expression 101. Win first down. Make 5, 6, 7 yards on first down and make it a 2nd and 3, 2nd and manageable. Keep accumulating first downs that way. Keep moving the football. You don't want to get behind the sticks because then the defense has the advantage.
Ready? So Bree's going to lead the Saints up here, 1st and 10 at their own 26. They start the drive on the ground. Kamara. And he's taken down but able to slip across the 35. 10 yards, good for a Saints 1st down.
Tremendous blocking by the interior of the offensive line. They didn't just gash him in. They blasted a gaping hole for him to gallop through. And if he comes back to the huddle, he better be giving them a whole lot of credit and thanking them for that much space to rumble.
So from the 36 now, 1st and 10. On play action, now Breeze. And it's caught, the tight end Hill. And a penalty flag is down to the backfield as they finally bring him to the turf. But I'm not sure this is going to stand. So a decent gain, but all for naught on the penalty.
It's too bad, isn't it? They were feeling pretty good about it. The only people celebrating, the guys who just gave up that play.
And he'll lose yardage here, going down back at the 28. That's going to wind up a loss of a full 3 yards on first down. Throwing on 2nd and long. Breeze. They'll set up the screen now to Kamara. A huge play there on the screen pass. 55 yards.
Well, partner, I'm not sure how this drive's going to end, but how about the way they flip field position there? A nice attacking play that picked up a heck of a chunk of yardage.
Field flipper there as all of a sudden they've got a 1st down in the red zone. From the gun, it's Breeze. And this is Cook with a grab. And he'll take it down here just shy of the 15 at the 16-yard line. Give him maybe a yard, quite the opposite from the previous big gainer. I know when you got a top tight end like this, you want to get him involved, but when you do, you're hoping for more than that.
You certainly are. You've got to try and get him some space where he can make a play downfield or at least an opportunity for some rack yardage, right, that run after catch.
Now a 1st carry for Latavius Murray. And he is going to be stopped cold behind the line of scrimmage. It's a loss of 4. Now 3rd down. That was shades of Tennessee Volunteer football back in the 80s with Charles Davis coming up from the secondary to make the tackle for a loss.
You mean my teammates doing that, right? Because they would tell you, my coach would say, where's that tape? I want to see that. But how about the complete package there? Not just playing the pass, but being a willing tackler and making a really nice play.
On 3rd and long, it's Breeze. incomplete.
Yeah, baby! Boom!
On fourth down, off goes Drew Brees, and on comes the Saints kicker, Will Lutz, for the field goal attempt. On the left hash mark, this is a 38-yard attempt. And Lutz's kick is good. And that'll do it for the first quarter of play. 10-10 our score after one on EA Sports. All level now at 10 apiece as the kick's away. This is taken at the 3. And he'll get it up to about the 26-yard line, just across the 25. Arizona getting ready to go as they take the field. And they had a long drive last time, but they had to settle for a field goal, and I'm sure that's how it felt to them, settling. They probably should have gotten in the end zone.
Yeah, not out and out joy, right? Because that's what you get when you put the ball in the end zone. But there are benefits to that type of a long drive. Your defense gets a chance to take a break, adjust a little bit, maybe get themselves ready to get back out on the field and play a little bit better. So they'll take the benefit even though they wanted the 6 points.
Yeah, maybe wore down the other defense. We'll see. Murray now on first down. Complete. It's Johnson. And this one will go to the 28-yard line.
Everyone's got to be able to catch the football. Doesn't matter what position you play, but if you're on offense, be aware, ball may come your way.
They only got a yard out of that last completion, and that makes this 2nd and 9. On 2nd down, here's Murray. Nowhere to escape, and he goes down. Cameron Jordan wreaking havoc with a sack. Great job defensively. I think he was trying to go through his progressions, find someone to get rid of the football. Before he knew it, he was on his back.
So that just brings us right back to what you said in the beginning. A great job defensively. Nowhere to go with the football. That led to the sack.
Well, that last sack puts Murray and the Cards in a tough spot, 3rd and long. Murray with a 3rd and long. Murray fighting, lost the football, and this is picked up by the Saints. And he's into the end zone, a fumble return, and a Saint touchdown. So the big fella gets on the scoreboard with a return for a touchdown. Good thing he didn't have to go too far, though.
You know the trainers were very happy about that. Imagine having to go get him in the end zone, escort him to the bench, and give him the oxygen. They were loving the fact that he got in without having to run very far.
Lutz will look to add the extra point. He's got it as they go up by a total of 17-10. So not only the cough up, but then the pickup on the other side, the scoop, and the score the other way, the fumble return for a touchdown. So here's the kickoff now as he'll get it again following that fumble return for a score. Fielded about a yard deep. And he'll take this up past the 20 and down at the 22-yard line.
Let's go!
Here's the Arizona offense now as they get set to take over. And they've got to be still reeling from the events of a moment ago. What a turn on that last play.
You're knocking on the door. You're about to take it in. You think you're going to get some points on the board. Instead, you cough it up and watch them take it the rest of the way to the opposite end zone. That's a two-score swing that you just gave up.
Murray and the Cardinals with a first and 10 at their own 22. Murray now on first down. And he'll hit the slant route. That's caught by Cooper. And he'll be corralled right around the 34. 12 yards the pickup. Good enough for an Arizona first.
You can see the time and effort and thought that they put into their passing game because it was evident right there. It looks like a simple pitch and catch, but you and I both know that they have planned for this and worked hard to make it happen.
On first down, it's Drake. And he is met quickly in the backfield. Down he goes, folded like a lawn chair. He came out ready to play. That's three tackles for a loss, Charles, rolling the second quarter.
And that's problematic for the guys trying to run offense because that means he's got a pretty good idea of what they're doing and is actually beating them to the point of attack and making those plays. Might have to think about some misdirection or something to try and get him away from the ball.
Quick strike here, Murray to Fitzgerald. And he'll get it up near the 35, right at the 34 here. That catch good for only a yard, and it'll be third down.
The goal of a wide receiver screen is get enough blockers in front to create a wall and let him pick his spot to run the football. How about the defense there, swarming to it and not allowing that to happen? Did not let him get downfield.
On third down, Johnson. And he'll go down to the ground at the 39, and obviously that's well short of the first. It's a gain of five on the play, and it'll bring up a fourth down.
I think we can safely say that those types of plays are the backbone of this offense. We know not every run's going to be a big hitter, but you know they'll take that type of result on each and every attempt.
On fourth down, here's Andy Leon to kick it away. Deontay Harris deep for New Orleans. And a nice job here to down this one right on the 5-yard line.
That is how you flip field position. That's an absolute bomb of a punt. Downs it inside the 5-yard line. Absolutely ideal.
From that position, you're hoping to get it down inside the 15, inside the 5. Superb. Drew Brees getting ready to go again on offense. He's played a pretty clean first half. A touchdown, no interceptions.
Frankly, that's what they expect out of him. They want to see the ball thrown and thrown well, and he's able to do that and put it in the end zone. They'd love to see more of that before this game finishes. But right now, he's got his team in a good spot.
A good spot, maybe looking for touchdown pass number 2 here in the second quarter. They begin on the ground with Kamara. And the running lane's non-existent in this first half as they'll stop him behind the line. They'll wind up losing 3 yards here. And it'll bring up a second and 13.
He has elite instincts from his linebacker spot. He's able to diagnose the run and flies in like a missile to stop that one behind the line of scrimmage.
A 3-yard loss to start the drive. They'll look to make that up and then some on second and 13. Breeze leaves this one with Kamara. And he'll get him a little bit of breathing room across the 5 to the 6-yard line. They'll get 4 on second down, but it leaves them with 3rd and still 9 to go.
Well, they didn't get a whole lot out of that one, but I think you've got to continue to try and run and try and keep the defense honest.
You mean, or else they'll just sit back, dare you to throw it on every down?
Yeah, you get your quarterback hit a lot that way, too.
Now Breeze on third down. And that's caught by Smith. And he gets up near the 25 to about the 24 before going out of bounds. Give him 18 there, and the Saints have a first down. And a good quarterback facing zone coverage, if he has just a little bit of time to survey the scene, that's what's going to happen.
No doubt about it. If there's no pressure, he's going to continue to pick them apart because he'll have all that time to find someone open downfield. You can only cover for so long. So maybe they want to go to a zone blitz scheme, get a little bit more pressure. Remember when Carolina did that against Denver? They lost the game ultimately. They dropped the defensive end out, and he ended up with an interception in that game in Super Bowl 50. Maybe some sort of scheme like that to try and get more pressure on the passer.
A solid run on first down. Gain of 7 leaves him with a 2nd and 3.
And there we saw one of the downsides of blitzing during a rundown, because sometimes you get out of your gaps. You don't fit the run quite as well because you're headed towards the ball carrier with abandon.
Single, slot. Hey, you're running out of it over there.
From the 31, Breeze out of the backfield. That's complete to Kamara. 6 yards the pickup, and that's a first down.
And a nice gain and a broken tackle along the way, and really we shouldn't be surprised, should we? That's what runners do, especially the best ones. They break tackles and gain extra yardage.
Now hitting on 80% of his passes in the early going. 8 of 10. It's first down. They run with Murray. And he's dropped right at the 40. Gain of 3.
When we see those runs to the perimeter, when we see those runs to the edge, we think about big breakers, don't we? In this case, it was a modest gain, but it does open up possibilities here on second down.
3 yards on that last carry. Here's 2nd and 7. Breeze now to throw. And oh, he took that in one-handed. What a grab. And he'll get it out a couple yards shy of midfield at the 48. That one, a first down pickup of 8.
Gotta love the catch. I think you gotta love the gloves as well.
Yeah, these one-handed catches, that was great, and they're fun. They've become a little more ho-hum, aren't they?
Yeah, they really are, and I know that it sounds like we're taking credit away from the guys, and we don't mean that at all. They really work hard on this one-handed catch thing, but I think the gloves have to be helping in a big way.
A good run there on first down, and it'll leave them with a 2nd and 2.
That's a strong pickup right there on first down. And as this drive goes on, we're seeing an offensive line and running game imposing its will.
8 yards the tally on that first down run. Here's 2nd and 2. Now Kamara. And this time he's able to take it down to the 42. 2 yards, good enough for a first.
Not too many more ideal situations at 2nd and 2 in order to try and pick up a first down. They ran it and picked it up.
Ready, rod 9. Rod 43. Rod 9, ready.
Breeze now on first down. And this one complete to Smith. And they're able to get this one past the 30, down to the 25. 17 yards on the catch and run. It's a first down.
Good throw, good catch, but I really like the route. The drag and being able to run away from defenders, hard to stick with them for that long.
Yeah, better against man than zone, or?
Better against man, because now you're running away from someone and you're not running into a defensive player in another zone.
Breeze going to come up here, 1st and 10. And he's 4 for 4 now, throwing the ball to start the drive. Working from the gun, it's Breeze. Now Breeze lost the football. So it goes as a fumble, but the key thing, not a fumble loss.
Yeah, that stat's big, isn't it? I mean, I remember watching teams play. The ball might be on the ground a number of times during the game, but if the other team doesn't get it, That's a huge difference in the ball game. And in this case, they were able to retain possession.
The first down play, to be frank, nothing short of awful. And now they have to deal with second and very long. Now Breeze. Complete. Smith has it. That one good for 17 as they're set up better now for third down.
They sure put the coverage guys in a stress on that one. They thought they were going deep. Ends up curling inside for a nice chunk of yardage.
The Saints on third down. They've hit 2 for 4 thus far. This is 3rd and 7. Shotgun now for Breeze. That's caught. It's Thomas. And down inside the 15, shy of the 10. A Saints first down there on a gain of 11. If you're going to blitz, likely going to leave you in man coverage with this guy, and that is less than ideal.
It is, because just about any offense that has an elite receiver, if you blitz and have him in man coverage, you're going to him, even if he has an elite defender on him, because he usually knows where the ball is before the defender does.
On first down, Breeze. He gets it complete to Harris. And he's going to be brought down just shy of the 5 at the 6. That throw good for 4. It's 2nd down.
One thing you're hoping for when you run drag routes, you're able to hit a receiver in stride and he can pick up a lot of yardage after the catch. But in this situation, the defense was effective, able to stop him before he could get a good head of steam going.
Hey, 4 down, 4 down.
Breeze on the draw, gives to Kamara. And he gets him a little bit closer. He takes it from the 6 inside the 5 to the 4.
I do know from experience that when you slow down someone's running game, you're now doing the dictating on defense. And guess what? Now you're getting ready to tee off on their quarterback because they have to throw it all the time. But you still have to be alert for the draws and other plays of that nature to make sure you don't get hurt.
This offense has converted 2 third downs on this drive already. This is 3rd and 4. Throwing now is Breeze. That is caught. Traquan Smith. Touchdown, Saints. 4 yards on the touchdown grab. And the Saints able to stretch that lead out further. On those slants, everything happens so quickly. What makes it work?
The timing between the passer and the receiver. In this case, a slant route ordinarily is probably about 3 steps before you go on the slant. In this amount of time, I think it was a 2-step deal. Boom, put his foot in the ground and got inside for the pass.
Got inside for the pass, got inside for the catch and the score. Lutz to try to add the PAT. And the lead is up to 14. And what a drive that was. 16 plays all told. And it ends with a touchdown for New Orleans. After the touchdown, Lutz to kick it off. This is fielded a couple yards deep. And no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line. Here comes the field general leading his offense back out there for the next possession. He's had a solid start to this game, but bottom line is they're losing, so he doesn't care about his stats. He just wants to right the ship on the scoreboard.
He wants to actually increase his stats because he feels like if he does, that means things will get better for his team, maybe get them back into the ball game or into the lead. In these situations, I remember playing with a quarterback once where he actually ran out onto the field first ahead of everyone else just to say, guys, let's go. Try and create that energy. can create that spark.
Well, so far he has one touchdown, one interception. He'll be looking for that second touchdown now. A nice start to the drive, picking up 12 yards there and a very quick first down. 12 yards the pickup, good enough for an Arizona first.
Partner, if you want more carries, I think we saw how you get them. Showed that he's got the fresh legs, and he picked up the first down on that run. Don't just ask for him. Show him that you're supposed to get the football.
Line of scrimmage, the 37 on first and 10. First down, Murray. Johnson's got it complete. And he's able to get this one out closer to midfield across the 45.
I know most of the time when the ball's in the air, you're thinking wide receiver, tight end, but running backs, they can be a big part of any passing offense nowadays.
That last catch short of the marker by just a yard leaves him with a very manageable second and one. Here's Murray. And that's going to be incomplete. The intended receiver was David Johnson, and it's third and short.
We've already seen him catch a few passes out of the backfield in the first half, unable to connect on that one.
Certainly seems like getting him the ball out of the passing game, though, is part of their game plan.
It certainly is, because he catches it well, creates a mismatch, either covering with a linebacker, a corner, a safety. They feel like he can win every battle.
To throw, it's Murray. Cooper's got it. And he's able to take it across midfield before going out of bounds. 7 yards there, good enough to move the sticks.
Would it be safe to say that as precise as routes are supposed to be run in the NFL, maybe they're not quite as precise in college ball?
That's accurate, yeah.
And I think we saw a college route in the NFL there. Just find the soft spot, find the dead zone, and find the first down. And that's what he just did.
So in Saints territory now, here's first and 10 at the 46. From the gun, a run for Johnson. And he'll get this down only to about the 46. Just a yard on the first down carry, so it's second and 9.
Well, we just saw a great example of what we talked about with his coach prior to the game. He's definitely one of the better linebackers at reading a play and flowing to make the stop before it turns into something big.
The run only got a yard. Here's second and 9. Now Murray throwing on second down. On the move to his left. And an alley to run. And this is going to be another first down as the tackle's made at the Saints 20-yard line. We've seen the pressure get to him several times in this game. There, though, we see him escape it.
And we've seen this rookie video before as well. That type of pressure, oftentimes, what do you resort to? Your legs try and escape. What you hope is that this doesn't become habit for him, that he learns how to handle the pressure, still keep his eyes downfield, and make some throws.
Hey, D-line, let's get in there. Let's get in there. Ready, go!
From the red zone, here's the Heisman Trophy winner, Murray. Stepping up, he's going to keep it. Good coverage downfield led to him taking off, picking up the first down on a 13-yard run.
Well, that was man coverage. So once he decides to run with the football, there's no one to account for him, and he turns it into a nice gain.
First and goal, and they got to be thinking a chance to get right back into this football game. On first and goal, Drake. And he is into the end zone. Touchdown, Arizona. Taking it in from 7 yards away. As his guys are back within a single score. Solid job up front. Really just a solid job all the way around to get that one in.
Yeah, that was well executed, wasn't it? Well blocked, well run. End result, 6 points.
Touchdown. Gonzalez now to add the extra point. He's got it, and it's 24-17. So that one, an 8-play drive, it spans 75 yards. And the exclamation mark at the end was Kenyon Drake's touchdown run. after the touchdown. Here's Gonzalez on to kick it away. This fielded a few yards into the end zone. And no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line. Alvin Kamara and the Saints set to start their next drive. He's been good. His guys are winning. So far, the recipe working here in the second quarter.
He doesn't like to just tote the rock. He wants to carry his team on his back, and that's what he's done throughout this game.
Yeah, he's done that. He'll be hoping to continue that trend. So Bree's going to lead the Saints up here, first and 10 at their 25-yard line. A 10th carry for Kamara, and he will lose yardage here back at the 23-yard line. A loss of two there, second down.
Came out in a power set, but that only served to put more men in the box. And guess what? If you're going to do that, you've got to win up front, right? Your offensive guys have got to beat the defenders. They lost all leverage on that play.
So the opening play of the drive goes backwards. Now they'll come up on second and 12. They'll run out of the gun with Kamara. It's a gain of maybe three, but it's going to leave them with still about eight or nine to go on third down.
Well, so many times we look at a short run and we praise the offense for trying to set the tempo and establish things, but the defensive guys, hey, they just won the battle there. It wasn't a big run given up. They don't always have to absorb the body blows. Sometimes they dish them out themselves.
From the gun on third down, Breeze. The open man is Smith. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. It'll be a Saints first down on a gain of 16 yards. Now at 200 yards already in this first half, and he's not done yet. First and 10. 2 minutes remaining in this first half of football.
Ready?
A reminder coming up here at halftime, we'll ship you off to Orlando. Jonathan Coachman will have first half highlights and analysis from a back and forth first half that we've seen. Now a throw left sideline here is complete. Give him nine there on the first down completion.
An ex-teammate used to tell me all the time, I hate experienced quarterbacks because no matter what, you really can't hide what you're doing. And I think that right there, he knew right away where the blitz was coming from, where his primary guy was going to be, and he ended up going to a secondary target for a nice game.
I was just
going to
ask you, that wasn't the primary target. He's so good at that, isn't he?
I think he knew right away that he wasn't going to get to his primary guy. I think he read that as soon as he got to the line of scrimmage, knew where the pressure was going to come from, and said, I know how to beat that, and that's what he did.
Throwing again on second down, Breeze. And he'll be brought down at the 48-yard line. 2 yards, good enough for a first.
That was a route run, not just with dexterity, but with intelligence. Found the hole in the zone, made sure the quarterback saw him, and was able to make the sure catch and put the down marker back to one.
Throwing on first down is Breeze. It's caught, Smith. He'll get this one down near the 20-yard line, just shy of the 20. A good pickup there, 26 yards.
When we watch Drew Brees practice, the thing that always strikes us is after every throw he makes, he continues to go through his progressions, you know, so he gets that muscle memory. Okay, in a game, if I don't have this throw I just made, I might have this one, I might have that one. It's amazing. One of the reasons he's come out so hot today, he's already seen it happen.
Bree's going to come up here, first and 10. And he's 4 for 4 now, throwing the ball to start the drive. That'll be complete to Cook.
Got to give credit where it's due. Really nice defense on that play. The pitch and catch was successful, but not any run after it.
So second and eight here after the pass play for 2 yards on first down.
Check it back.
Again, they'll throw with Breeze. Again, has it complete. The Saints going to call the first of their timeouts as they get the stoppage with a little over 50 seconds to go in the first half. Breeze now on first down. And he's going to be taken down, sacked back around the 18-yard line. Now we'll get a quick timeout called by New Orleans, number two, as the clock shows 50 seconds to play here in half number one. Now following the sack, they'll look to make amends on a second down and 17. Breeze now. Thomas has got it. Complete. That catch good for five. It's third down.
Fired that one in there. Able to make connection on a nice in route.
With those faster passes and they're going that fast, any hesitation as a quarterback that the deflection, if you miss, might be bigger and lead to an interception?
Yeah, and the deflection works both ways. Maybe a defender gets a hand in the way and it pops in the air. And sometimes you throw it so hard your receiver can't handle it and he pops it up in the air for the defenders to grab as well.
But a moot point. And he is into the end zone. Touchdown, New Orleans. Drew Brees does it again. Three first-half touchdown passes for him now. And the Saints able to stretch that lead out further.
CD, it seemed like they were so focused on the guys out wide, they forgot about him out of the backfield.
That's a really good point because you got to communicate, and oftentimes when you start counting receivers, that's exactly what you do. You start from the widest receiver, work your way inside. Who gets lost sometimes? The back in the backfield. That's exactly what happened there.
And he got into the end zone.
Lutz good on the extra point. And the lead now up to 14. So that one a long 11-play drive. And it all culminates in a Saints touchdown. After the touchdown, Lutz to kick it off. That's fielded in the end zone. And not wanting to risk anything here late in the half, he'll just take a knee and they'll bring the football out to the 25. Arizona getting ready to go as they take the field.
You've got less than 30 seconds left here in the half. You're well on your own side of the field. What are we doing here, Coach Davis?
Well, I'm trying something on first down. And it's something that's safe. It's something that's been done many times before. A lot of people say it's not even worth trying, but I'm running a draw. I'm running a screen. I'm seeing if something pops. And if it does, that can alter my strategy and potentially get me some points. And if it doesn't work, well, then you just run the clock out and go to the locker room.
Clock at 20 seconds to go in the half as they come up first and 10. And they'll indeed start on the ground to run that clock. And he's not going to go anywhere as they get him down behind the line of scrimmage. Yikes, a 4-yard loss really sets him back now for second down. So we have come to halftime in what's already a 2-touchdown game. As we send you on over to Orlando for Jonathan Coachman at our EA Sports Halftime Report. Take it away, Coach.
Okay, right, Brandon. Thanks very much. And welcome in, everyone, to this slimmed-down version of the EA Sports halftime report. This one has certainly been one-sided to this point. It's a 2-touchdown difference, as the teams have already come back out onto the field for the second half. So let's get you back out as well to Brandon Godden and Charles Davis.
All right, Coach, thank you, and we welcome everyone back for quarter number 3. Set now to go for the third quarter. The Saints have the lead and set to receive the kick. This is fielded a couple yards deep. And he'll take it up past the 25 to the 26-yard line. Out come the Saints now. They'll go on offense first here to begin the third quarter. They built a good first half lead. Now they have a chance to add on to it.
And what I'm thinking is that the offensive staff spent the entire halftime just working with them on, here's what we think they're going to do to attack us in the second half. Nice first half that we've had, guys, but be prepared for some change-ups. We're going to see them when we kick it off in the second half.
See how they handle any adjustments that might be made defensively. So Bree's going to lead the Saints up here, first and 10 at their own 26. Now Breeze. This is caught by Gim. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. It'll be a Saints first down on a gain of 16 yards.
Well, they obviously, red man covers their partner, and he got downfield, broke down the defender, made him
think. What do you mean by that, bro?
Yeah, he made him think he was going to run a different route. Probably thought he was going to take it upfield, and then he curls back inside for the completion.
One play has him up past the 40 already, and another first and 10. From the gun, it's a run for Kamara. It's the Pro Bowler Chandler Jones who makes the tackle.
Third quarter and you've got the lead. You're not ready to go into that 4-minute offense to close the game out, but a running game can really benefit your team right now.
At the 46-yard line.
The first down run got 5. Here's second and 5.
Hey, let's get some penetration here.
Breeze now to throw. And that one got tipped, kind of threw everything off. It brings up third.
Well, we're not playing 3 yards in a cloud of dust football anymore. I kind of get why those old school coaches sometimes didn't want to throw the football. Because if it's popped up in the air, it almost turns into slow motion. And both sides trying to get to the football, and you're holding your breath wondering whether it's going to go good or bad for your team.
Now Breeze. He's got Smith here. 2 yards is all they'll get on the completion. It's fourth down.
One of the money routes for any offense, the drag route. So tough to defend because the receiver can stop at any point and make himself available to the quarterback and get a completion. But I love the communication we saw there. All the defenders pointing out the receiver, where he was going, and then they're able to rally to the ball after the catch and stop him short of a first down.
Here's Thomas Morstead now, as he'll kick it away for the second time. And no return possible here as they angle this one out of bounds. The Cardinals offense now ready to get their first opportunity here in the second half. They're down in this game. A chance for the offense, though, to put something on the board, get some momentum here in half two.
Try and get things kick-started for them. And you know at the half, they discussed how they were going to get that done. This is where scripting comes into play a lot of the time.
How many plays do you script coming out of the second?
Most of the time in the first half, you're scripting 12 to 16. I think in the second half, you're really scripting more like 8 to 10, kind of a starter or an opener, whatever terminology they use, just something to get you off to a quick start.
Here's Murray as he sets to throw it. He's got a man complete. It's Clay. And the result here, a pickup of 8, leaves him with 2 to go on second down.
Let's just break this down and make it pretty simple. Key to the drag route, letting the play develop, finding the hole in the defense, and giving your athlete, yes, athlete, a chance to make something happen once he has the ball in his hands.
Facing a second and two after that last catch, good for 8 yards.
He's got the connection to Cooper. And he went nowhere. Well, he went backwards, back to the 33. This offense in desperate need of a conversion as they come up on third down. Throwing is Murray on third down. And he will not be able to hang on through the contact. It's incomplete. The coverage strong, and now it's fourth down.
You hear the calls for a penalty, but I just don't think so. I think in this situation, the defender is making sure his guy couldn't hold on to the football. So I don't see anything to warrant a flag.
No, I'm with you. There was contact, but I'm happy they kept that flag in the back pocket.
Here's Andy Lee now as he's on to punt for Arizona. And that one hits at the 7, but bounds into the end zone, and that'll be a touchback. The Saints coming out now to take the field.
This crew had to punt last time they had the ball, but when you've got a lead like this, you content to play the field position game?
You are to an extent, especially if you like your defense, because you have the lead, you've been controlling the game. But why put them in a tougher spot? You want to get out there and get something done on offense and maybe take command of this game yourself.
So Bree's going to lead the Saints up here, first and 10 at the 20. They'll try to get the offense going with Kamara. And he's going to get a solid gain of 9 before being brought down, second and right at a yard.
First play of the drive, let's give credit all around. Excellent blocking, but the guy carrying the ball, he was the finisher. A really nice run.
Up at the 29 now, they'll head to the line, second and a yard. They run it again with Kamara, and they'll take him down at the 31-yard line. 2 yards, good enough for a first.
Second and one, and people want to run the football. This is where every back in the league is supposed to do exactly what we just saw there, pick up the first down.
Line of scrimmage, the 31 now on first and 10.
Watch safety green. Watch safety green.
They'll run. This is Kamara. And he is met in his tracks behind the line of scrimmage. It's a loss of a yard there, and now second down.
I have zero rooting interest in either team in this game. I only want a good game. But with all the offense we've seen from them tonight, it's kind of nice to see the defense step up and make a big play.
Yeah, I was wondering if they were ever going to get him in the backfield. Nice to see him get a stop.
Ready. Yellow waiting. 43. Check. 43. Record. Good
night. Now they'll throw with Breeze. He gets it to Thomas. And he'll be taken down, but not before they work it across midfield. Last play, they got stuffed at the line. Different story here, over 20 yards. All the yards, completions, just another play that's a feather in the cap of the great career of Drew Brees.
And wasn't he supposed to be too small to be an effective quarterback in the NFL?
Yeah, how'd that work out?
Yeah, well, his footwork, I think, really sets him apart. Remember, he was a junior tennis champion, beat Andy Roddick, the future U.S. Open champion, back when they were in the juniors. I think that footwork really helps him be the great quarterback he is now.
This quarterback now over 300 yards now for the game, and time to improve on that as he's got a first and 10. The throw from Breeze into the hands of Smith, and he gets it inside the 35 and just shy of the 30. Give him 18 there, and the Saints have a first down. And with that last play, he's now up over that 300-yard mark.
And in today's NFL, it almost feels routine. And I hate that when you talk about a 300-yard passing game. To me, 300 yards still signifies excellence, and he's achieved that in this performance.
Breeze now. Five straight completions here in this second half. First and 10. Off the play fake to Kamara. It's Breeze. The catch made over the middle by Ginn. And taking it to the 15-yard line before he's brought down. It'll be a Saints first down on a gain of 16 yards. This drive, it's been a good mix. Three passing plays, three runs, hitting on all three of those passes, and the last one putting him in the red zone.
So wouldn't you think play action right here? Because you've got the ability and had the ability to run it and throw it. Go play action and take your shot at the end zone.
Ready? Y'all waiting? 58, come on.
All day, dog.
Play, play. Breeze now on first down. And this one complete to Smith. And he'll get him inside the 15 down to the 14-yard line. Give him a couple on the catch. It's second and 8.
When you see zone defense and you know you've got a drag route on as your primary call, you've got to be really careful as a passer about how far you let your guy go because he might wander into some tough coverage.
So second and 8 here after the pass play for 2 yards on first down. A man who's been busy this afternoon, it's Kamara again. And he is going to be stopped cold behind the line of scrimmage. He lost 2 there, and it's third down. This offense has had a lot to like in this game. I don't know that that last play, though, is going to make the highlight reel.
It's not going to make the highlight reel, but it will be the focus of the film session that the team has to sit through. I've sat through those before. Never any fun. You're always excited about your good plays. And they actually fast forward through those. All right, that was good. All right, great. They get to the bad ones and really illuminate them. Not cool.
Now Breeze on third down. Looking left side and he's got a man. It's Murray. And he is out of bounds, getting it down to the 10. Call it a gain of 5. And that's going to bring up a fourth down.
Whether you're playing West Coast offense or not, one of the maxims of the West Coast offense is you're either throwing a touchdown or a check down. In other words, look for the big shot, but be smart. I think they did exactly that on that play. They didn't get the first down, but they're taking care of the ball well.
Yeah, and being rightly cautious with that lead here in the second half. So they put together a good little drive there, but ultimately stalling out in the red zone.
Yeah, I know a lot of people look at it as a little bit of a negative. They didn't get 6 points out of it, right? Didn't get the touchdown. But that's actually okay. They got 3 points, able to give their defense a little bit of rest, let them settle down over there. So all in all, to me, that's a good drive.
Field goal, Lutz to kick it away. This will be taken in at the 1. And he'll get it up across the 20 to the 21-yard line. The Cardinals offense now works their way back onto the field. And with this deficit, you can't have too many more drives like the last drive where you had to punt it away.
You know what I would tell my offense right here? The punter doesn't exist, guys. He doesn't even exist. He's not a team anymore. I just cut him, all right? So you've got to go out and create some offense for us here and give us some points. No way does that guy get on the field on this drive.
Poor punter.
Yeah, it wasn't his fault. But hey, listen, there's got to be casualties at times. We're trying to win a game.
To throw, it's Murray. And his throw is going to be incomplete. Larry Fitzgerald was the intended target, but it's going to be second down.
Let's face it, if you want to get back into the game, these are the kind of throws you've got to hit. He's wide open right there. Got to be able to get it to him, don't you think?
And those are the throws that haven't been available to them every time he's dropped a pass. Yeah, that's a big miss. From the 21, it's second and 10. Back to the air on second down, it's Murray. He'll get this into the hands of Byrd.
And he'll have this past the 30 prior to going out of bounds. A gain of 10, first down, Arizona.
People worry about throwing the out route because often it can get jumped, and that can turn into an either an incompletion or an interception. But not on that one. Everything came together, and he catches it and goes over the sideline.
Murray now. Five straight completions here in this second half. First and 10. A run on first down, but it's not going to get him much. Maybe a yard, and that's all. Just a yard on the pickup there, and it'll bring up a second and 9.
They tried a quick hitter inside, but that one was swallowed up because what they're hoping, those big defensive linemen will take the bait and move laterally and open up a crease that they can run through. Didn't happen on that play.
They stay on the ground. This time it's Johnson. And they're going to get him behind the line yet again as his nightmare afternoon continues. It'll go as a loss of a yard, and it'll set up third down.
But these guys are going to chop into that deficit. They got to do a much better job in the run game. Caught behind the line of scrimmage, no yardage would be found.
This offense in desperate need of a conversion as they come up on third down. From the gun on third down, Murray complete. It's Johnson. It's a gain of 11 and a Cardinal first down.
And we see another pitch and catch there to the running back. This position just continues to evolve. They become just as critical to the passing attack as a lot of receivers, tight ends, because their ability to make people miss in the open field can really generate big plays for an offense.
Set, cut, took the pitch, bro. Right there, 56. I know he ain't got it.
Murray's going to keep this himself on the RPO. Murray, a quick throw out to Kirk. And he'll lose yardage here, back at the 41. That's going to go as a loss of 2, and it'll be second down.
Now that was well defended, and as a cornerback, what you're taught when you see a wide receiver screen, either you get underneath the play before the blocking forms, or you're going to have to fight your way through it by getting through some blocking. That was a really nice play there.
Second down, it's Drake, and he is met quickly in the backfield. Down he goes, folded like a lawn chair. Call it a loss of 2 on the play, and it's going to be third down and a ways to go here, third and 14.
Well, that's pretty symptomatic about how things have gone here. That play was just shut down right from the start.
And not going to give him a lot of confidence to help turn things around.
Couple of plays sent them the wrong way, and now they face a third and 14. Murray with a third and long. He gets this one to Johnson, and he's going to be stopped here at the 43, and that is not near enough to pick up the first. Andy Lee now, as he's on to punt for Arizona. And problems spreading to the punt team now. This one goes all the way into the end zone on the fly, so that'll come back to the 20. Drew Brees getting ready to go again on offense. How do you think he personally is evaluating his game so far? He was pretty good in the first half, been good so far here in the third quarter. He's got to like it, right?
Not looking for the dramatics here. Not trying to set the world on fire in terms of stats. It's almost like you're driving. Hands at 10-2, alert for anything out there, watching for trouble on the road, and making sure you get the team home.
The bus driver. See if he can drive the bus here again on this drive.
Tonight. Play action. Breeze. Going down the middle, and it's complete. And he'll be corralled well upfield right around the 40-yard line. Great way to start the drive. 20 big ones and a first down.
One thing I can say pretty safely, that route is not called if you don't have a guy who can throw the ball and put some mustard on it. Because if you're going to lollipop it in the middle of the field, bad things usually happen. It takes a strong-armed guy who can rifle it in there, and they were able to successfully complete that one.
Ready. So quickly ready, all the way up at the 40-yard line.
Hey, it's just me and you. It's just me and you.
Kamara. And he'll push this forward only to about the 42-yard line. Give the tackle to Hassan Reddick.
That's a good play by the guys on the defensive side of the ball. Held him to a gain of two. And that changes the playbook a little bit now for the guy calling plays. Second and eight. Now he's got to probably think about going to the air instead of maybe staying with the ground game.
Throwing on second and eight. Breeze on the check down. He finds Kamara. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. 10 yards, good for his Saints, first down.
And this is why trying to cover the angle route is so difficult. Anyone playing the linebacker position, when they see a running back out of the backfield widen, because he heads towards the flat first, oftentimes you widen too much and overcommit. He cuts up inside, and that's what we saw there. A nice pickup for a first down.
Trying to get out wide, but he's going to be tackled right near the line of scrimmage. Tackle made there by Jordan Hicks.
Perfectly designed blitz right there. They took that one from the grease board to the field because they were able to free up their linebacker to get into the backfield and spill the play.
Officially nothing on that last run. They'll try again, second and 10. They run from the shotgun with Washington. Give him four on the ground there. They're now left with third and six.
But that call makes sense because they've been throwing it well on this drive, and once again they show passing formation, showing the shotgun. Then they ran out of it. That's a nice play by them defensively, though, to hold it to a short game.
They'll need to get this to the 38. That's where the first down marker is here on third. To throw is Breeze. They'll set up the screen now to Kamara. And this time he's able to take it down to the 42. And the screen only good for three that time, and it'll bring up a fourth down. Instead of throwing it downfield, Charles, they just tried to dump it underneath there. Do you like the call?
I do. I think it's a high percentage play because you get the completion, and what you're counting on is your back to use his legs and his elusiveness to make people miss and pick up the first down. In this case, it didn't happen.
So coming on now is the field goal unit. They're going to try for three, and he'll need all the leg he's got here. This will be spotted just shy of midfield, a 59-yard attempt. And this kick is not going to be close. It's well short, well right to boot. And this score will stay right where it is. Well, I was watching him in warm-ups, and he hit a 62-yarder that hit the crossbar and went over. This one a little bit inside of that, but not enough leg.
And the difference is what?
Well, your live conditions,
right? Live conditions, game conditions are a whole lot different than practice, where you just pop it up there, no rush, no pressure. I think maybe that takes a couple yards away from you when you have to do it when it's real.
Ready to go with their next drive and at the line, the Cardinal offense. And down on the scoreboard, certainly needing to avoid what happened on the last drive, punting the football. Oh, now Murray has it stripped. And this is picked up by the Saints. Taking it right down Broadway. And he's into the end zone. A fumble return and a Saint touchdown. So that is now two fumble return touchdowns. You're talking about something that's going to drive a head coach crazy.
Without a doubt. But for the defensive guys, once you do it once, you create a frenzy. Everybody wants to get involved, and they got it done a second time.
Lutz will look to add the extra point. And he's been a busy man, 5 for 5 now as he knocks another one through to extend the lead. The scoop and score, always an exciting play in football, and we witnessed it there, grabbing it off the ground and then rumbling it into the end zone for 6. And you can bet they're preaching 2 hands on the ball here as the kick's away following that fumble return. This fielded at the 2. And he'll make it across the 20 as his guys will set up shop at the 23-yard line. The New Orleans defense, we get set to watch them go. And they had the fumble return for a touchdown, and boom, they're right back out there again.
And you hear so many people talk about opportunistic defenses in today's football. Well, they make their own breaks because they work at it all the time. We've been at the practices, the drills where they're trying to strip the football, the takeaways. They're always working on it, and it paid off for them on the last possession.
Paid off. Now can they do it again? Murray and the Cardinals with a 1st and 10 at their own 23. Play action. Now it's Murray. This complete to the tight end, Clay. No gain there on the completion. 2nd and 10. Well, he caught it right at the line of scrimmage, and before he could even think about advancing it forward, he got hit.
Great tackling, because that's what you're taught. Don't give up yards after the catch, and most offenses make a living off of yards after catch. Those hidden yards that may not go into the score sheet, but they count big for moving the ball and stretching the field. Really nice open field tackle.
And they're going to get this beyond the 40 before he's taken down. That one, a gain of 20 and a 1st down.
It certainly feels like there are more stars at the tight end position than there were even 10 years ago. And I think it's become more of a glamour position because of the ways it can hurt a defense, and guys want to be involved. They can be in line, close to the line of scrimmage. They can split out like receivers. But hands, route running, speed, and some toughness to go across the middle, you put it all together, you got a heck of a tight end candidate.
That's what I do. Murray now on 1st down. He finds his man, Johnston. They'll give him a yard on the play, and it's a 2nd down.
A gain of a yard brings up 2nd and 9 at the 43-yard line. That's the end of the 3rd quarter.
And they won't be able to run another play. Time has expired on this 3rd quarter. And that'll do it for the end of the 2nd quarter. This is the NFL, and it's on EA Sports. They only got a yard out of that last completion, and that makes this 2nd and 9. Throwing again, Murray. Underneath for Johnson. Give him 2 yards on that play, and all of a sudden here, it's 3rd down.
It's a gain of 2 yards, and it's 3rd down.
The Cardinals on 3rd down. They've converted a 3rd of their opportunities, 3 for 9. This is 3rd and 7. To throw is Murray, and able to find Kirk complete. And this is going to be another 1st down as the tackle's made at the Saints' 29-yard line.
Has a pretty good throw on the curl route there. 3rd down, and they pick up a 1st.
Defense should be aware for that, right?
They should be aware, but it was so hard sometimes.
Yeah, it's not easy.
Because when they sell that route really well, you think they're going upfield, then they curl back, show their numbers to the quarterback, and complete the play.
So signs of life in what's been a dormant offense in this second half. Here's first and 10. First down, Murray. And that incompletion breaks a string of five straight connections. And it's second down.
Well, the trials and tribulations of being a quarterback in this league, it's tough. It's got to be wearing on him out there.
Well, he has been sacked a number of times. He had an interception, so I'm going to give him a skosh of credit for hanging in there and trying to make something happen, despite the amount of pressure he's been under this entire game.
To throw on second and 10, Murray, and an alley to run. That one a broken play, but it ends up being a good play. The scramble goes for 20. Not only another first down, that also puts him over 100 yards rushing.
That's not something you see very often in the NFL. We see it more in college. But I think with more of the melding of the college game with quarterbacks, we'll see this a little bit more often in the future.
And what can they do here on second and goal? Three red zone trips so far have yielded two touchdowns and a field goal. On first and 10, here's Murray. Now he'll pull it down. He'll get just a yard on the scramble. It's second down.
Looked to me like they adopted what my kindergarten teacher always said. If at first you don't succeed, try again. And finally, able to hold him in check. He'd been carving him up running the ball.
That's the first time I think I've seen where the coverage was good downfield and they accounted for him and stopped him for a short pickup.
Yeah, I don't think it was a big adjustment, but much more emphasis on making sure they knew where he was when he decided to take off and go.
And he'll take this from the 9 down to about the 7.
Partner, I know we're in a goal-to-go situation. But my goodness, think about running the ball here. Not even a thought, is
yeah,
it?
Yeah, defensively, they're in a prime spot.
And I think the defensive guys are probably expressing themselves to them as well. I wouldn't run it here, guys. You might want to try throwing it.
This has been a long drive. You got to figure a field goal would be a letdown. Can they convert now on third and goal? The quick slant caught. Well, this is going to depend on the spot, but it's not a very generous one. He looks to be about a yard or so short. A terrific job there to keep him out of the end zone, and now it'll be fourth and goal.
And a lot of people ask the same question all the time. Why do we see so many slants in the red zone? Well, the windows are tighter. Everything's more condensed. It has to be quicker, and you've got to deliver the ball on time. Your biggest worry? Ball gets tipped in the air, because if that happens, then it's fair game for the defense.
A field goal does you no good, so they're going to stay out there and go for it on fourth. Murray and company going for it on fourth. And the Cardinals are in. Touchdown. They've already been on record as saying, hey, if our rookie quarterback's going to tuck it and run on a scramble, we kind of hold our breath. Well, that was a maybe no, yes, as he's able to get into the end zone.
Are you saying he's got to learn where the line is about whether you keep your eyes downfield, try and find a receiver, or you tuck it and go? And I think there's going to be some growing pains with that. I think in this case, he made the right decision.
And we know he's got the speed. He showed it there.
From the gun, Murray, rolling to his right. He's going to take off with it. And he will get into the end zone to shave two more points off the deficit. Well, it's still an uphill battle from here, that's for sure, but that makes it a two-score game.
And now we see why teams practice so much on the two-point conversion, why you have more than one play ready, because you may need multiples to throw out a ball game. There's a great example right there.
Now after the touchdown, here's Gonzalez on to kick it away. This will be taken in at the 1. And he'll get across the 20 before he's brought down at about the 23-yard line. Now whistles, and we've got a man down. A man down here following the kickoff. Well, he gets attended to. We'll step aside.
Ready?
Getting set for their next drive, the New Orleans offense. Well, there are two scores on the plus side. Still time here in this fourth quarter, but maybe you start thinking about playing keep away?
Yeah, I think here's the situation. You're not thinking touchdowns anymore. You're just thinking first downs. To keep up with your theme there, playing keep away, first downs, they can't touch the ball. Brent, it's clearly a running situation when you're up in the fourth quarter. They're going to have to stack the box and make it difficult for them to move the ball.
Made it very difficult right there. Now they need to repeat that effort.
Yeah, bring 7, 8, 9, whatever it's going to take to slow them down.
First play of the drive goes the wrong way. Here's second and 12.
Tight down. There you go.
Shotgun now for Breeze. Gets this to a standout receiver, Thomas. It's a pickup of 12, and that'll set up a third down. He's played a great game. It continues right there, even with this lead, confident to throw the pass and have the reception made.
There's no doubt who the leader of their team is, is there? There's no doubt who they want to ride all the way to the finish, because strategy would tell you run the football, run the clock down. Instead, they're letting him throw it because they feel that confident in what he's getting done.
And he went backwards. He'll be down at the 30. It'll wind up being a loss of 2. And that'll bring up fourth down.
No surprise they decided to throw on third down. A little bit of a surprise that they completed the pass and lost yardage on the play.
Here's Thomas Morstead now as he's on to punt for New Orleans. This is taken at about the 14. We'll call that a punt of 54 yards. Well struck. And the Cards will take over, first and 10. Here's the Arizona offense now as they get set to take over. And for them, a touchdown their last go-around. Obviously, they'll be hoping to do that again.
And when you start plotting for this drive, when you start thinking to yourself, okay, what are we going to do? You don't go away from what you did before because that worked, but you have to be prepared for wrinkles and counters because you know they'll make some adjustments.
Murray and the Cardinals with a first and 10 at their own 23. Murray now on first down, sliding out of the pocket. And he's going to keep it here. The coverage may be too good that time as he breaks away for 19 with his legs and a first down.
Partner, as a quarterback, sometimes you just got to know when the clock has gone off in your head, it's time to go. Tuck it and get all you can.
One play has him up past the 40 already, and another first and 10. Throwing on first down is Murray. And the Saints pressure gets him. Brought down for a sack. Sheldon Rankins abruptly ends that play with a sack. And no matter what the situation, the O-line just hates that because they feel like they didn't protect little brother back there, right?
Yeah, and that's just so difficult for them because just think about every single play. When you decide to throw the football, you're dealing with some of the best athletes on the planet. You talk about guys, if they weren't playing football, they'd be starring in the NBA at power forward. It's a really difficult task.
Don't need it all back at once, but you figure they're going to need something here. 17 yards to go on second down. Murray going to throw. Open man is Kirk, complete. And he'll be out of bounds, but able to get it up past the 45. It's a pickup of 12, and that'll set up a third down.
Partner, he sold the go route really well. Thought he was going deep, then curled it back inside for a nice completion.
DBs love when they pump the brakes, don't they?
Yeah, that's really a whole lot of fun. It's almost like you said, listen, if you're going to sell the go, just go. Well, let's see who's faster.
Here's Murray, and this is going to be incomplete.
And that's a crusher right there. Had his man open for a first down. Threw a fastball when that wasn't necessary. Incomplete pass. When are these quarterbacks going to learn? You don't get extra points for how hard you throw the football.
They're already already slim hopes are going to ride on this one. They'll go on fourth down. Murray sets to throw on fourth. Escaping the pressure right. He can run for it, and he will. The Cardinals unable to convert there on fourth down. And that will force a turnover on downs. So they really needed points here in a two-score game. Could not come away with anything there on fourth.
And while we know they're a little bit discouraged here, they can't check out of this game. You and I have called a good number of games over the course of our career where we've seen these types of situations. Teams get the ball back, and that miracle does occur. So they can't let that dream go just yet. They have to get stout on defense here.
Yeah, right now, really hoping for a turnover. A good starting spot for the Saints as they come up first and 10, just shy of midfield at the 48. On the counter, here's Kamara, and he'll be brought down right at midfield after a gain of only a couple. Offensively with the lead, you want to run the ball, keep the clock going, but you also want to still kind of be in attack mode too, right? So how do you do that and not come back on your heels?
Think about all the practices we've watched where they have that tempo period to go over things just like this, where they describe the scenario, tell you what they're looking for, and make sure that they're still attacking, yet at the same time not going so fast as to leave too much time on the clock.
And he's able to get this one down to the 40-yard line. 10 yards, good for a Saints first down. Now I'm guessing you'd say this is kind of the key here. Grind out some yardage, work on that clock, see if you can continue to tick it down.
Definitely, you want to bleed things out at this point, right? Continue to possess the football, gain some yardage, and put the onus on the defense. Do they have to use timeouts? What are they going to do to stop you? You're taking charge.
So after the run by Kamara, now another first and 10.
Six man.
From the shotgun now, here's an inside give. And Kamara has it stripped. And the Cardinals have got it, going the other way. And his guys are going to take over at the 39-yard line.
Partner, that one looked like it was over. I mean, they had control, had the football, and the defense had to make a play in order to keep them in the game. That's exactly what they did.
And now that door ajar, two-score game, so hold on here, not done in the fourth. Arizona getting ready to go as they take the field. And last time they were very fortunate, this offense. They went for it on fourth, turned it over in their own territory, but the other guys held up. They didn't give up any points.
So how about the guy with the number one headset on the sidelines, the head coach? That was planned going into it, not necessarily to not get the first down or to have the defense have to hold up.
But he trusted his defense.
Trusted his defense very much, and I think that that's how he's going to play this game. Go for it, be aggressive, because I've got the wild bunch backing me up over here on my own sideline.
Now we'll see what his offense can do. Throwing now is Murray. Johnson's got it complete. Not able to go anywhere that time. Second down. Fourth quarter, every drive so critical, and you figure may only get one more shot after this, so a touchdown's imperative on this drive.
It is, but you also have to think to yourself in play calling, don't hold anything back. Don't save it for the second touchdown. You've got the first one for the second one to even matter.
Had the completed pass, but for no gain, stopped right at the line, so it's second and 10. Here's Murray as he sets to throw it. And it's incomplete. Christian Kirk, the man he was looking for, and that takes us from second to third down.
If you're a defender, one of the fun things about playing zone defenses, especially in today's football, is that it's not as static as it was in the good old days, meaning you just dropped to a point and reacted to the football. Now you end up with a lot of man-to-man principles once you get into your zone defense. In other words, get to your assignment and then locate a guy coming into your area, and then you end up covering him almost man for man. That allows him to make more plays on the football like the one we just saw there.
Good coverage downfield led to him taking off, picking up the first down on a 13-yard run.
Sometimes guys get locked into such a groove. What do we call it? The game slowing down. They see everything happening almost in slow motion. They see the lanes develop. I feel like he's right there.
Well, and you want this from your leader, right? With this deficit, this stage of the game, second half, no quit in him.
Zero.
Let's go, D.
On first down, Murray dumping it off for Johnson. It's a 4-yard pickup, and it'll be second down. Four yards on that last completion, so that sets up second and six. Now Murray completes it to Fitzgerald. And he's got this down a yard or two shy of the 40 before he's out of bounds. 4 yards on the completion, and it sets up a third down.
Timing is everything, and they work on this cut all the time. They work on all the timing patterns, and this time it paid off for them. Worked him to the center of the field, cut it to the outside, ball's delivered, gets both feet down for the completion.
Third and two, and here's Murray. And he's got Fitzgerald. And this is going to be another first down as the tackle's made at the Saints 21. A two-score game, obviously, every play, every third down, like we saw there, magnified, big pickup.
It was a huge pickup. What they really want, though, is to not even get to third down. They've got to maximize time and conserve as much as possible.
First down, Drake, and he'll get this one down to about the 17. 3 yards on the pickup there, and it'll be second down.
Not too many offenses want to turn down long drives, but when you're down what they are, they've got to pay it off with some points.
The last run got three, now here's second and seven. On second down, here's Murray. And that'll be incomplete. Took a pretty good shot as he tried to pull that one in. Couldn't hang on, third down.
It went with a dime look on defense. Two extra defensive backs on the field and covered up essentially every blade of grass. That allowed them to disrupt the play.
This will be the eighth play of the drive. It's third and seven.
I can't believe they let you play. I can't believe they even let you play.
Throwing is Murray on third down. He's got a man complete. It's Clay. They get only four that time as that leads us to a fourth down. He got out of bounds. That's a good thing, but still short of the first.
And now, since this brings up fourth down, the defensive play caller, grab your nerves, because now you don't want to be so amped up that you give them a first down by getting out of your lanes, but you also don't want to just lay back and let them have it easily.
All right, they're going to try and keep hope alive here on fourth down. They're going for it. They're going for it. It's Murray. And this is incomplete. The Cardinals unable to convert there on fourth down. And the Saints will have the football back. So a tough pill to swallow there. A would-be touchdown pass in and out of his hands on fourth.
Sometimes it just comes down to execution, doesn't it? Because we're always questioning, should they go for it, should they not? Is it the right play call, is it not? In this situation, everything was right except for the finish. You have to catch the ball and convert.
The Saints offense now, they get ready to head back onto the field. Big stop on the turnover on downs to get the football back, and now it's just all about salting this one away.
Yeah, just slowly bleed the clock away. Clock's definitely on your side. And, you know, when we talk about analytics in the game, what is this one? Advanced win metrics? Because if you take care of the football here, bleed the clock down, were they about 95% chance of winning?
Oh, yeah,
it?
I'd say 95 or better. I know you always say it, every coach does. It's just protecting the football at this point.
And knowing that the defensive guys, they're coming after the ball more than they are the person. They want to knock it free.
Now a play fake here on first down. And this one complete to Smith. And he finally goes down at the 23-yard line. A big play.
play there on the catch and run. 63 yards. They have the nice cushion. They just want to pour it on right now, still throwing the football.
And I know my background says, why do you need to do this? Just go ahead and run out the clock and get a win. But as many people pointed out to me, this is a video game, man. Go ahead and put the numbers up. Sportsmanship, not an issue.
Exercise those fingers. So barely time to catch our breath. Here's first and 10 just outside the red zone. And he will lose yardage and be backed up to the 24. What a difference a play makes. A huge step forward and now a small step back as he loses a yard or two. Under four to go now as the clock runs and they come up on second down. On the ground, Kamara. And give him about three as he gets it down to the 22-yard line.
Bottom line, they want to keep this clock rolling, so they'll take that one right there. They just want to keep falling forward, and they won't put the onus on the big fellas up front in order to bring this one home.
In need of a conversion on third down. They had the big play to start the drive. Not much sense. Working from the gun. It's Breeze. And he's going to go down. They sack him back right around the 30. Rodney Gunter able to get in there for his second sack of the afternoon.
Well, how about that? A dime set on defense. Six defensive backs. None of them blitz. They're just back there in coverage. Defensive lineman gets the sack.
That's where the O-line, they go to the sideline, they keep their helmets on so the cameras can't find them, right?
Yeah, the cameras can't find them, but I know one thing, the O-line coach will.
On fourth down, off goes Drew Brees, and on comes the Saints kicker, Will Lutz, for the field goal attempt. This to make it a three-score game late. The kick by Lutz is good. And that will make this now a 19-point advantage. So with that, you figure, this game's pretty much out of reach at this point.
Yeah, it's going to take a heck of a comeback to come from three scores down. But don't change that channel. Don't go away. Miracles can happen, and you want to be here in case it does.
You're a company man.
Now, aren't I, though?
The made field goal, Lutz to kick it away. That'll be taken in the end zone. And he won't return this one. He'll go down to a knee, and they'll start at the 25. Here's the Arizona offense now as they get set to take over. And on that last drive, went for it on fourth, turned it over. Good job by their defense, though. They held him to three, but this offense, they've got to be a little bit better, a little bit more careful here.
And sometimes when you see these calls on fourth down, when they decide to go for it, it's not necessarily the coach saying, I believe in my offense. Sometimes the coach saying, I believe in my defense. I can afford to go for it here, because if we don't get it, I don't think we'll give up more than three. And that's exactly what happened.
You think that factored in?
I do. I think that he had that in his mind going into the game, that I'm going to be aggressive on offense because I know I've got a defense that can hold up their end.
Give him a couple on the catch. It's second and eight.
That was a nice throw out there to the flat, but they defended that pretty well. The hope is to go ahead and put it on him so he can turn and get upfield and gain additional yardage. It just wasn't anywhere to go on that play.
They'll break the huddle, come up on second and eight at the 27-yard line. Murray now. And he finds Fitzgerald. 27 yards there, a first down.
First down, Arizona.
2 minutes left to play in this football game here on EA Sports. So the Cardinals, they've got the football here as we get you reset. And let's see what they've come up with offensively after having time to talk it over. Murray now to throw. Now a desperation throw. And this is caught. And he is into the end zone. Touchdown, Arizona. Damir Bird, his second touchdown of the afternoon. And the Cardinals cut into that lead.
He put quite a bit of air underneath that touchdown pass. Of course, we knew that he had the strong arm.
That part was easy. You could see that throughout his college career. But what you want to know about a rookie is, when the pressure's on, can you throw with touch? He just did right there. And boy, it was pretty.
Still an important piece of business to take care of, the extra point. And they're able to cut the deficit to 12. The drive there only spanning three plays. And the Cardinals cap it with a touchdown. Two scores down, three timeouts left. Still a chance if they can somehow get this one back. And the Saints hands team able to rein this one in. They knew they needed a miracle. They had to have that onside kick. They didn't get it.
Well, as we knew, even before they put the toe to the leather on that one, their chances of getting that done, slim and none. And I do believe we saw Slim just leave the door, didn't we?
We did indeed. I think we're down to none.
Back out onto the field now comes the New Orleans offense.
And a few kneel downs should just about do it. Now, defensively, they do have all three timeouts, but very little reason to use them at this point.
Off the defender. The Cardinals going to use the first of their timeouts as they'll talk things over prior to this upcoming second down play. This, in all probability, another run here on second and eight. Again, it's Murray. And they'll be inside the 35 now at the 34-yard line. Now the Cards going to call another timeout, their second. And they'll be disappointed to have to burn one there after giving up the first down. Not totally home free yet, but it's looking good as they come up first and 10.
Set the tone, defense. Let's go.
On the ground, this is Kamara. The Cardinals forced to burn their third and final timeout as they'll talk things over prior to this upcoming second down play. Here's second and nine, just a yard on that last run. Again, it's Kamara.
And he's going to have to protect the football and take his lumps here at this stage of the game as they stop him behind the line. It's a loss of two, now third down.
Hey, a lot of points have been scored in this game against them, but tally that one on the side of the defense.
Do you think maybe, possibly, it can be a little bit of a changer for them? Maybe not a game changer, but a little bit of a momentum one that maybe they can string together some pretty good plays and slow them down.
Ready? 95-56, 95-56.
I got it.
On third down, here's Kamara. And they will rally and stop him short of the first down. They get him to the ground at the 26. 9 yards on the carry there, but it'll be fourth down now.
So much of the game today, we're looking for hybrid players, guys who can do a combination of jobs. And anyone who plays a strong safety position, now more than ever, is a hybrid type player. Half defensive back that covers passes and half linebacker that makes tackles. We just saw the linebacker make that play.
So they'll turn to the kicker again. He's been a busy man thus far. From the left hash mark, this a 43-yard attempt. And Lutz puts this one through. And that will make this now a 15-point advantage. So they settle for just the three, but clearly right now anything helps trying to salt this one away in the fourth.
Without a doubt, obviously a touchdown probably would have been the final nail to finish this thing off, but they still ate up time, got points. So while it's not mission accomplished, it's darn close.
Following the main field goal, Lutz to kick it away. Gets fielded in the end zone. And he'll elect not to return this one, so they'll bring it out to the 25 on the touchback. Ready to go with their next drive, and at the line, the Cardinal offense. They have a little bit of time left here, but this one not going to go their way.
And this is where, in this situation for me, you just go ahead and run out the clock, shake hands, congratulations, and move on. Because now, you're not going to make up for what's happened during the game in this last sequence.
We'll see what they do here in this last sequence. An incomplete pass leads to second and 10 from the 25. Back to the air on second down, it's Murray. He's going to let it fly. And he knocks the ball away and it falls incomplete. Coverage there by Von Bell. Now they face a third and 10 after back-to-back incompletions. Murray, one final try. And this is intercepted, and that should do it. Picked off by Marshawn Lattimore. And he will take this one home. It's a touchdown. And that one will pretty much erase any hopes of a fourth quarter comeback.
With emphasis, interception, return for touchdown. Door closed, locked, reinforced.
Now the final act of this victory, the extra point. It's up and good, and they add one more to what will wind up a fairly lopsided victory. So we had action to the very end of this one. The score on the final play that they didn't need to have. They didn't just run out the clock, though. They added to their final total.
Played it all the way to the end, and you know, some coaches preach that and tell their teams, that's what I want all the time, and they feel like if they don't do it themselves, they're not living up to the message that they're sending out.
So that's a wrap for Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gunn, and this has been a presentation of the NFL on EA Sports. For more, check us out at easports.com. I'll be heading to the hotel. Charles, he's off to Bourbon Street.
No, I'm not.
As we say so long from New Orleans.